I've been hoping for snow. The tree just outside the window is giving a nice pop of color to all the white with all the bright red berries. The look of red berries against white snow always reminds me of old fairy tales. It just has such a traditional, folksy look. As much as I would love to spend the entire day wrapped up in a blanket by that window, we must venture out into the wide, wild white to run some errands, visit some friends, and generally explore the area. I love the feeling of being safe and secure inside of a car while something is happening. Whether it's raining or snowing or even just going through a car wash, it takes me back to being a little kid, not having to worry about anything, just being along for the ride and getting lulled to sleep by the hum of the engine. The homes around here have such an old colonial style, much different than what I'm used to. So the view on this drive is a lot of fun. I also enjoy all of these cobblestone walls lining everyone's properties. They look very handmade in the best way. Our first stop is Main Street in downtown Concord. As you can see, the snow has passed for now at least, and the sky has transformed from that hazy gray blur into a pale blue. These streets are lined with brick buildings, full of antique stores, candy shops, barbers, many of them with signs saying since 1912 or since 1936, or stopping by this specialty wine and cheese shop to pick up a few items for a dinner party tonight. The place was absolutely bustling, so I've concluded that Concordians love their cheese and their wine. Admiring these grand old buildings like the church, the bank, the post office, we're also lucky enough. Even though the snow stopped, it is still quite cold outside, so it'll be nice to go hide inside the heated shops. Tucked in between two storefronts was this narrow wooden staircase leading up to the store lit by a lantern. The shop is called Nesting, which is fitting. Now it's time to head to our next destination. We're visiting a friend's house and are given a warm welcome by their cat. In their basement is this elaborate you look at it, the more you find. There's so many details tucked away in unexpected places. And if you peek underneath the table, you'll see what looks like hundreds of intertwining wires they've painstakingly installed to power each and a central city life, and also more remote areas of farmland. I love peeking into these tiny windows of the buildings downtown and seeing the interiors of apartments. There's even a music shop. By every now and then, complete with sound effects. We're off once again. They seem somewhat happy to be cuddled and pet, but are mostly eager to just get back to sleep. It's incredibly tiring being a puppy. So very much growing to do in so little time. Each one looks slightly different. Varying shades. They definitely are not solitary beings and much prefer the puppy pile approach. It was fun to watch them kind of unsteadily hobbling around. The museum here was closed for the holidays, but still had a courtyard open to walk through. This entrance gate reminded me of a secret garden with overgrown greenery draped over the brick pillars and curling wrought iron. A twisting staircase leads down from the gate, covered in crunchy orange leaves left behind from autumn. The courtyard overlooks an only slightly frozen lake with a wooden bridge. The sun is setting, so the trees across the bridge is where the Revolutionary War began. It's marked by a monument that reads, "Here on the 19th of April, 1775, was made the first forcible resistance to British aggression." On the opposite bank stood the American militia. Here stood the invading army, and on this spot, the first of the enemy fell in the war of that revolution, which gave independence to these United States. Now, back at home, the birds are feasting on the berries. These are American robins. I was reading about them in a bird watching guidebook and have some mad knowledge to drop on you, so prepare to be amazed. These guys are well suited to withstand pretty cold temperatures throughout the fall. They hard at work growing lots of additional feathers for insulation, and to keep warm while roosting, they fluff their feathers up with their beaks. throughout the winter days, they're eating. They're one of the very first birds to sing at dawn, and their song sounds like someone saying, "Cheerily cheer up, cheerily 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 cheer up." It's evening now, and the snow has returned with a vengeance. The snow is still such a wanted to just go out and experience it. So I stood out in this wide open field for a while out by a farm. Thankfully, I was well bundled up, so it was comfortable. The wind was swirling the snowflakes around and rustling. And there is the end of our lovely winter day in Concord, Massachusetts. Thank you so much for